What's up, everyone? It's Kaisen here, and welcome back to The Awakening. We're still in Act 4, Cruel, no worries. I just went back to Act 3 because we're going for a gear upgrade. And for that, I do want to get something from Clarissa here. And to be more exact, I do want Enfeeble. So we're going to buy this for an alteration. It is at level 36 only. Okay, so apparently it stops at some point. But that's actually not too bad because we want to combine it with cast when damage taken. And the one that we have right now, you can see that it says this gem can only support skill gems requiring level 44 or lower. So that means we can maybe level Enfeeble once more. But then we'll keep it at level 6 or maybe 7, depending on what the required level is for it. So we want to put these two in the new chest piece. And you guys have seen this one before. We do have a decent life roll. It's not that great, but we have increased armor and two pretty good resistances. And what we can do when we go into our hideout is that we can put a third resistance on it with the armorer's bench. And I can show you guys something that might be interesting for you as well. I don't have them in my hideout anymore. Wow, talking is really hard today. But Haku is level 6 now. And that is actually relatively important because at level 6, you will get increased values on your armor's workbench. What is that? Am I not online anymore? Okay, I am. I have some issues with my wireless right now, so I wouldn't be too surprised, to be honest. So you can see here that for what we're looking for, which is lightning resistance, there's this one for level 20, costs 6 augmentations and is 21 to 25. And with the level 6 Haku, I just got the 26 to 30 lightning resist, which is a bit more expensive. But it obviously gives you a bit more resistance as well. And we're going to go for that one. So we'll put it in. We will go for the higher resistance roll. And hope to get 30, obviously. 28. Well, I mean, that's average. I'm not too sad about it. I still think this is a really, really good item. And we can probably use it all the way to maps. Now what we have to do, because we need one blue in this three link here, so we have to see that we can get the blue somewhere. Nope. 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 There is another option. I'm just going to keep going this way. There's another option of paying a certain amount of chromes to get one off color. But I still don't know if it's if the off color would be... Yeah, it could be like this. This would be one off color on the item, and it's still not, it doesn't help me because it is not part of the three link. Okay, I'm burning quite a few chromes here. Okay, we finally got it. So now we have cast when damage taken. So whenever somebody is dealing more than 725 damage to us, Enfeeble will be self cast, will be automatically cast, and that means from then on, that enemy will not do as much damage anymore. The accuracy is decreased, crit strike chance, crit strike multiplier, and obviously the damage straight up. So that's a defensive setting that I think at this point we can go for. What I could do as well, I haven't leveled this, so it's probably not too effective as at this point, but I'm just going to put it in here. So when I take the damage, it casts Molten Shell as well. I'm just going to try this out and see what it does. And I'll level... what do I have in here? Anger. Okay, I have to put Anger in here. And... okay, I'll just keep those in here. So we will switch this armor now, and you can see that we will lose a bunch of evasion. But we will gain a lot of armor. So we go from 10% damage reduction to 30, and we drop from 33 evade to 21, which I think is still an upgrade in terms just percentage wise. And also, I do believe that Act 4 has a lot of bosses that deal physical damage. So I like the damage reduction. I think this should make Act 4 easier for us. The last thing that I wanted to do is I found Inertia the second time around. And I already showed you guys that if you go on challenges, there is there are all these jewels here that you're supposed to corrupt. And Inertia is one of them, so we're just going to use a Vol Orb. We have three of them, so we can just go ahead and try to corrupt it and hopefully get something interesting. I don't think that did anything. So we basically just wasted the Vol Orb, but we got the completion for Inertia. I just want to... Let me see. So this is the corrupted one. Dexterity. Oh, it actually decreased the strength value. Or maybe that's... It might be that this was... kind of had a range as well. So I'm not quite sure if it actually decreased it. Anyway. So that was what I wanted to do at the start of the episode. And now we will go back into the Crystal Veins. And we will continue in Act 4. I'll probably have to record two episodes right after each other. Because... Oh, actually, no. It's not quite the case. We'll go into Kaom's dream first, because I think it is easier. And then the Resso comes after this, so let's get everything ready, and we're going into Kaom's. Alright. If you guys have actually been using the same build and playing along, or, you know, trying your own, I'd be interested to know how it worked out for you guys and how you're doing. Because, I mean, so far I haven't had too many issues, but I think from now on it will get quite difficult until you get to a certain point. I'm hoping that the armor upgrade will actually do something for us and will make it easier. Because when I tried it with a similar character before, you can see how fast Molten Shell is leveling right now. And that character had a pretty low amount of armor and had a really tough time in Act 4. So let's see how that turns out. All right. So far, so good. This is level 50. What level am I? Okay, I'm level of the zone. I know I usually say that you don't necessarily have to kill something when it's a same level zone or even below your level. But Act 4 is a bit different for me. I know that I will have to face Malachi Cruel relatively soon. And I do have to say, oh, here you go. My cast when damage taken actually went off. I am a bit scared of the bosses in Cruel here, to be honest. What level is this now? Okay, it's level 12. So we can keep going for a while. Because they do hurt. Not so much Piety, because I think that Piety, the damage can be easily evaded. Dodri will be pretty tricky, and Malachi deals quite a bit of damage as well. So it will definitely be interesting to see how we fare. Oh, and I think the most dangerous ones are actually the two that we are going towards at this point. So, Kaom is really scary, and the Wrestle is it's not bad as well. Okay, so the cast when damage taken setup seems to be working fine. It's level. Enfeeble should cast. Okay, I want to get hit and see if this. Yeah, okay, it works. You can see those guys are enfeebled now. Beautiful. Oh boy. Okay, that was a lot of damage. Yeah, I'll just, you know what. We'll fight him. I'm just gonna clear all of this first, and then, we're going in. Just to show you guys that, yes, it looks like they're dealing a lot of damage, and they do, but you can easily fight him. It's a bit more about kiting, obviously. Okay, let's get our guy back up. Here we go. You do have to move. You definitely have to move. Alright, here we go. Okay, that was a good one. Yeah, and we almost got all of them down. Let's just get our guy back up. Man. Okay, let's get this guy. Here we go. We got him down. And this guy seems to hurt as well. Alright. Not too much of an issue. But it definitely does hurt. Okay, we don't need any of this. Got here. Let's just open it up. Nice. So you should definitely make sure that you have the cast when damage taken set up. I think cast when damage taken you got normal Act 3 or I think it was normal Act 3 or maybe cruel Act 3. But it was a quest reward, so you definitely do have it if you have been following the Let's Play. And as I said, Enfeeble you get from the vendor in Act 3. So, ooh. All right. Okay, we have two at the same time. Let's just get rid of them. Rakongo, I will not fight the unique boss in here. I can kill him, but it's super dangerous. And I feel before maps, we don't really... I want to try to make it deathless to maps, so... I don't see why I should risk it this time. We will have enough of a challenge... going up against the likes of Malachi. And whoop. Whoa. Okay. Lag. Yeah, going up against Malachi and Kaom. And what's his face? The Wrestle. So. That should be enough. Just to show you guys the Battleborn, the card that we just found, it just says X. Not quite sure what that means at this point. It's some sort of axe, but it would be I would be curious to know what eye level they're talking about. If it's an high eye level axe, I don't know. Is it a fast one? Is it a slow one? It's just there are some weird cards that don't really tell you anything. It's the same as the life armor cards that we already found. That's great, but it doesn't really tell me anything. And I don't think that the... yeah, I think I checked. The cards don't really have an item level, so... It's kind of weird. It doesn't really... So how do you know what item level the item has when you change it? Does it have to do with your own level? Or... I don't know. Okay, that's kind of tiny bit dangerous here. So let's get them down one after the other. Let's get our friend back up. What the? All right. This guy as well. Yep, we want this. All right. Transmute, thank you very much. I think we should be almost through. Oh, is this a dead end? No. Okay, we can keep going here. So you can see that you're definitely taking some damage here. At some point, I do want to add the powerful crits. Okay. I do want to add the setup with Fortify, because I think that will be a big step towards becoming really tanky as well. So once we get a few better items with the right sockets, or if we get good items, we'll just link and socket them. Then we'll definitely put that in, which means we will use Whirling Blades as something to get from A to B. Oh, okay, that's the guy. Yeah, not gonna fight you, dude. Whoa. Okay, my game is... Do you guys see that? That was kind of scary, especially at this point. It might have been because of it. Maybe there was too much going on. But... Okay, I do have to get through here, though. And there's a blue one as well. Okay, fuck that. Yeah, I'm just going straight up here. Not messing with that. Alright. Cool, cool, cool. So we basically made it. Should be the entrance up here. Well, we can definitely fight these dudes. No problem. Another one with powerful crits. I should probably open this one now. Because if there is something like revive on there, it would be annoying. Because I just killed them for nothing. Alright. So let's see what we get as a drop here. Oh, this guy is still here. Okay. We'll take generosity. We'll obviously take the Orb of Chance. And I mean, this is an intelligence based shield, but there's no spell damage on it, so there's no inherent value on the shield, so I don't really pick those up. Although they, I think, have an increased energy shield value, but I do value the damage a bit higher, so that's why I'm not going for those. Alright, let's keep going. Wow. That was a lot of damage coming in from all the dogs. Okay, Molten Shell is at level 24 now. So it's quickly going up there. Here we go. we might need a damage upgrade at some point as well. I mean, I am still running around with two links, so maybe we have to get onto a three link at some point. I would, for that to be viable, I would like to finally, okay, well, what is this? We can, next level is 39, so that's still okay. So let's upgrade Enfeeble. We do have to do more and more Elrion quests or abandon his mission every day so that we find an upgrade for this one at some point. It could be both. It could be a ring, or I don't mind an amulet as well. I mean, this amulet is—it's not amazing. There's some rarity and lightning resist on it, but that's all it has. So I wouldn't mind using an amulet with the minus two to skills. Pretty flexible on that. But it, obviously, it has to be, okay, I have to be a bit careful here, because I don't think I can straight up tank all of them. Yeah, it should be a minus 7, minus 8, and it has to have a decent base as well. So as soon as that is a given, I'm up for investing currency on it. And just putting it on, obviously. Alright, here we go. We will try to stay towards the left-hand side here. Because my experience is that the entrance to Kaom's arena is on the left-hand side, mostly. What is this? Extra damage. Okay, so let's be a bit careful here. All right, we got him. Let's go in. Oh, we're already filled up again. Okay. Okay. So, this will be the last little bit of this episode. I am planning on finishing this, so defeating Kaom at the end. Hopefully we'll get it all done in a decent amount of time. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. That looked a bit dangerous. What's this guy do? Okay, increased crit strike. That is obviously super, super dangerous. So that's why I was taking a bunch of damage there. Let's get all the piles. And is that a decent? Nope, it's not. Okay, so we're climbing up, climbing up. There's some void bearers here, which we should be fine against. I mean, our fire resist is usually the least problematic one, because we have some passives that basically increase it even further. Oh, we don't have them yet. Okay, but we will get them. Some more coming our way, and you guys will drop like flies, same as you. Now let's make it this way. I might be going the wrong direction at this point, but we'll see, we'll see. Alright. If I do, this is just a bit more experience. But there seems to be a way here. So let's just follow it and see where it leads. Choo. Powerful crits and a lot of extra damage. This guy looked really dangerous, but I don't know. Didn't really do much. So what is it down here? Is there anything? Because I don't see anything down here. I have the feeling that this is a dead end. We'll find out shortly. I mean, it is that. Wow, English. It's definitely a dead end down here. Now let's just pull our guy back up. Yeah, I don't think there's anything here. Okay, let's just go back, because we're just wasting our time here. It has to be somewhere up here. Nope, not here. Choo. Let's get this. All right. That's what I meant with up here. This is looking promising already. Yeah. Okay. We are at the right spot here. What? That's just resist elemental damage. Okay, so they're not that dangerous, but I'm still kiting back a bit because I don't want to be surprised by, you know, the amount of damage that they deal and just drop. It's a lot about my hardcore mentality. A lot of softcore players will probably just jump in here and don't really care about it. Okay, so this is monster level 56. I am 55, slightly underleveled. Let's get our guy with back up with full health. And for Kaom, I do have 2.2k damage with 42% cast speed modifier, which I think at this point is not that much. We do have our cast one damage taken set up with Enfeeble now, which should make the fight a bit less dangerous. We have 30% physical damage reduction, 21% evade, 75, 75, 75, minus 8, and 24% chance to block. Okay. Now, let's see how this works. Okay, so yeah, you can see he already deals some damage. I'm just trying to... Whoa! What the hell? Okay. Yeah, this might be interesting. Because he is dealing a bunch of damage to me if he hits. So I do have to evade, ideally, all of it. And now, these guys, I have to get rid of them as soon as possible, because otherwise they will deal way too much damage. It's not so much about getting my flash charges back, which is nice, but it's just about getting rid of the damage source. And the same will be once he spawns his little friends, the summoning raging spirits. They will be quite dangerous to me. So I do have to see that I get rid of all of them relatively quickly. Oh man. He deals some serious damage. I have to make sure that I'm not really in melee range, because that is scary as hell. Okay, I'm trying to constantly still deal some sort of damage to him. Yeah, okay. Now it gets interesting. Because Okay, I get him down relatively quickly. Whoa, and I'm lagging. That's not good. Whoa. Too much damage. Let's get the distraction up. Just running in circles for now. The good thing is that I was able to refill my flasks a bit. And I think we can get him down now. Let's get my friend back up. Yep, nice. I do have to curse him again. Get a bit more health back. Woo. And he's down. He's down. Come on. Am I hitting him? Okay. Nice. All right. That was definitely a bit more intense than it was on normal difficulty. You can see that, especially in melee range, he was hitting really, really hard. He was hitting for like 2k. So, don't go in melee range. Try to get him staying a bit further back, and always use your... I had my decoy as well. I was not really using my decoy, just because I was kiting too much, so I didn't really have much time. So when I had some time, I was always resummoning my flame golem, because I had the increased damage with it, 18% increased damage, and it kind of... I use it as a decoy totem as well. All right. Nice. That was one of my biggest concern, this fight. So I'm happy that we didn't die doing it. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos. And I'll see you guys next time.